It's a beautiful day here.
Wow. I'm vlogging. Right.
So I just grabbed my guitar, and as I mentioned on a previous vlog, I'm experimenting sounds with my guitar and Pro Tools, and experimenting with reverb and other stuff. And I'm using this cheapy mic here. I put this cheapy mic, it's by Audio Technica. So here, like this. So I'm using this sound, an acoustic sound from the guitar. And my pedal board, of course. I'm using the Pog number 2, that is great. Now you can hear the sound of the Pog. That's really nice. Yeah, super warm sound. And in conjunction with the mic here, that now is off. Let me turn on the mic. So yeah, it's now the Technica. Yeah, so like this, see? So I have a mic here in the hole, and this is the box of the mic. It's a Pro 70, right? Audio Technica. Right, so here you have it. You have a sound of the acoustic guitar, so you can listen this sound kind of more acoustic, and then you have the sound from the pedal board, so the Pog too. And I also have the Hall of Fame reverb, very nice. Yes, I just broke my guitar today, and I feel like practicing a little bit, and maybe start with some basic exercise, like just to warm up my hand. It's also a good idea maybe practicing with the metronome. Stuff, you know, just anything that I want, actually. So now I'm playing just minor Dorian all around the fretboard, and I also start with the arpeggio, like a very simple stuff. F, B flat, and so on and so forth. So this is a nice thing to start and to get my fingers moving. And yeah, also just arpeggio. Arpeggios without moving all around, maybe it sounds like an exercise, of course, but once you get into, for instance, G7 arpeggio, like, so you have a lot of options in the guitar. Here, maybe this one, maybe. Right, so a lot of options, like I said, to play a G7 arpeggio, but when it comes to time to improvise, maybe you start just messing around with some chromatic stuff, like, for instance, reaching each tone for G7 in this case, so B, G, F, and D. Right, so sounds more like a phrase. See, it sounds more more musical in a sense, but eventually if you practice arpeggio first, you get to know all the positions. So it's a very, very important step, at least for me, just knowing all the arpeggios and inversion of the arpeggio, right? And so eventually you start to improvise for Jimmy Solidian. See, so I can play actually whatever I want. A lot of chromatic stuff, but eventually I land on one of the tone for G7, so G, B, D, and F, so B root, third, fifth, and minor seven. So you get the idea to practice like this. Also, in a rubato fashion, you don't have to practice the tempo, maybe just. See? And when I play in this area, I know, of course, this arpeggio here. And then. Sometimes my student ask me about how can I practice arpeggio and how can I improvise fast when it comes the time to play, for instance, G7 in this particular case. And you really have to know the arpeggio on the fretboard. There's no any magic in this. You just need to know this or this or. Move around, just trying to play something. And on the six now, so you can actually play whatever you want, whatever you feel, whatever you hear, and land on six now. Actually, a lot of chromatic stuff, like. Or. See? And eventually I know this here. But it doesn't come out in this way, like. Right? But comes out like a. Right, like this, or maybe. Like this. Yeah. Actually, I also use some triad here. Like triad pairs, like for G, G, F. G and F, like I really like the sound of the triad pair. Right, and of course when you in a mono situation like G7, actually, harmonically any chord that comes from the C major scale. So if you have, for instance, I like to use for G, I like to use the B of diminished arpeggio, because it sounds perfect for G7, because you're actually playing the major third, the fifth, the seventh, and the ninth for G. So it's a great arpeggio to play for G7. So if you have G7, you can actually play just the arpeggio, and it sounds good because you're reaching all the tone for G7 and 9 attention, right? So you have, so it's good to know, of course, all the F diminished arpeggio. So you have, right? So for G7, and so I can combine maybe some line. See? Descending here a line, melodic line, and maybe descending with your arpeggio from here. Right? So try to experiment arpeggio combined with chromatic stuff, and also, like I said, with some other arpeggios that comes from the same tonality. So for G7 Mixolydian, you can actually play any, like I said, any chord or arpeggio from the C major, because G7 is the fifth mode for C major. So if you have G7, I can play also C major 7. And you're actually reaching the 4th, right? So it sounds like a sus4 chord. So if you play C major 7, you get the 4th, the 11th, you get the D, that is the 5th, you get the G, the root, and the B, the major 4. So it sounds actually very good on G. So if you have a, sounds great. I mean, it's just a piece of vocabulary that you already know. So you know C major 7 arpeggio, but you're using this on a G7, right? So a great tool to use. I always tell my students, you really need to learn the arpeggio, not just because you have to learn them, you know, because I'm telling you to learn them, because are very important when it comes the time to improvise. And if you go to listen to very good improvisers, and they know all the arpeggio, of course. And of course, it takes time to learn all the arpeggios, but you have to start somewhere. So just start to practice them, and maybe one area of the neck. The guitar is super difficult, actually, for improvised music, because you have a lot of different options to play the same arpeggio. And if you saw some previous vlog on this channel, I constantly study arpeggios all across the fretboard. And so if I have, for instance, D minor 7, let's take, D minor 7, I can play D minor maybe from here, or maybe, now I'm reaching the 11, but as you can see, very different shape. And that's why guitarists tend to learn shapes, of course, and memorize them. But sometimes we need to pay more attention on notes. So if I have D7, I want to know D, F, A, and C, right? So just try to tell the name of the notes. So D, F, D, F, A, and C. D, F, A, and C. So you really know the name of the note, right? The super. Yeah, and then it's just a matter of line and phrasing and transcribing a lot, of course. But first, for me, it's super and still is super important to practice arpeggio like every day for maintenance. I feel kind of tired today. It's 10:30 now, yeah. And I need to get into my editing and mixing process for the record. I need to take a coffee first. Alright, so the vlog for today is done, and I hope to catch you on the next one. Thank you.